Hello, Libra. This is Bonnie from Soul Star Bliss with your June 2021 mini tarot reading. Before we take a shuffle and get started, I'd like to just tell you I'm going to be doing a money and love combo video. I'm going to pull three cards for each and see what happens. Let me know what you think about that. We'll do that for June. And also a reminder that this is just a general reading. If you'd like one just about you, I've included my website link down below. Please click on it. Get yourself set up. We'll get to it as quickly as we can. And last but not least, you may want to check your sun, your moon, and your rising sign, as they sometimes connect more than just the sun sign. So with that said, let's see what's coming up for you, Libra. For June 2021, let's take a look here. Ooh, here we go. Let's see what is going on here. Okay, it seems like there's going to be, I don't know, some kind of remembrance or a flashback or something like that that brings sadness. And I think it has to do with a loved one that was lost or crossed over. And it's just real important, and whoever this is for, is that they're okay, and you too will be okay. And not making light or making small of it, but I just felt like I should pass that message on to you. Seems like victory for Libra this month. It seems like the trials and tribulations, is what I heard, are coming to an end for a lot of you. It's been a tough few months, maybe even a year. But it says excuses are gone now. You're going to see that things are going to get so much better than they have been for so many. And it says that be brave enough to make some choices. You know, we're all afraid. You know, well, what if I choose wrong? Or what if I do this? Or what if I do that? And it says when you know what the answer is and you choose that, then just wait for, you know, divine intervention or divine timing to show up, and it will be okay. Messages are going to be important this month. And messages are like real messages on your phone, in your mailbox, in your email, something like that. It just says make sure you keep up on your messages. And I know a lot of times it's hard to find the time to do that. But it says to make sure that you do, because I think there's something in there that's going to be inspiring or give you hope or something you've been waiting to hear about. It says there's going to be quite a few changes this month, and most of them are going to make you really happy and help you move forward with something. It says your intuition too is really like that gut feeling that you get about something. You know, should I go here or should I not go here? Trust that feeling that you're getting, because it's I think people are more in tune with themselves than they realize. And it's just important that you learn how to use that, or trust, not use it, because I think you use it every day, is to trust that would be a better way of putting it. Maybe your finances are a little wonky is the word, or, you know, they're good today, not so good tomorrow, something like that. I feel like there's some kind of balance coming due to the shortage for whatever reason, whether it was, you know, the pandemic, layoff of work, whatever it is, it looks like things are going to, I just feel like, settle down and be more consistent. Okay, that's the word I was looking for, consistent. And quickly things change. You know, it's been a long, it's been a long dusty road, so to speak. And it just looks like things are really going to, you're going to feel better. You're going to want to get up. You're going to want to go to work. You're going to want to, you know, be back to the old grind of work. And, you know, but you know what, a good lesson for all of us is learn to breathe and play a little bit too. You know, work isn't everything, although if you've been without it for a long time, it's pretty darn important. But it's, I keep getting the word balance, you know, like balance between work and play, balance between love and, you know, whatever it is. It just seems like balance is going to be real important this month for you. So really pay attention to, you know, where your time is going or where your energy is going, and see what you can do about that. And make sure you have time for you and your family. It seems like a lot of folks have been doing for others, which is awesome when you can, but don't cut yourself short. Don't do more than you can. For those of you that are having any kind of health issues or reoccurrence or something like that, go get that taken care of right away, whatever it might be. It might be just a visit to the doctor. It might be a pill fix, is it? But let's just not postpone or put off that. You know, if you got headaches, go get your eyes checked. If you know, your teeth are hurting, go to the dentist. And you're going to find by getting it early is going to be a lot less expensive, and it's probably going to be a lot easier to fix. And all of us humans seem to think that that's not something we want to do. But it could be necessary here, either for you or for a family member. And I just feel like when you deal with a situation or get the help that's needed, the care that's needed, it'll be a lot easier for you. And it says, don't move forward with guilt. Okay, I don't know why, but I'm picking up guilt for choices that were made. We all do if you're doing the best you can with what you have, don't beat yourself up over that. You know, do we make the right choices every time? No, we don't. Do we do everything that's right? No. No, we don't. We're human. And so we're allowed to have a few mistakes here and there. You know, I mean, I don't know anybody who is perfect that's on their earth walk. But something about that's going to change. It's like you know what to do. You're able to make the decision. You're able to move forward. It just seems like you have a to-do list. Okay, check. Okay, got to go here. Check. And it's like, rather than being up and down and all over the place, it's like you're getting real organized with personal things, like family and personal things. With work, you're awesome. But it just seems like, you know, maybe on the home front, you need to be a little more with that checklist. And then just check things off as you go. It says, whatever you're waiting for, maybe it's already here and we don't notice it. I know that sounds weird, but sometimes we're waiting for joy. I believe we choose joy. And if that's the case, choose joy. You know, you deserve to laugh. It's okay to be happy. It's okay to be well. And, you know, don't blame yourself because somebody else is not happy or joyful. And sometimes that you have to remember that's their choice. But there's things in the works for you, okay? It's like at work. The choices that you're making are going to be really good for you. And just the reminder here is, take a little time for you, Libra. You're entitled to it. You've earned it. With that said, this is Bonnie from Soul Star Bliss, and I'll see you again next month.